Hello and welcome to Modeling Data Relationships with OutSystems. This is a follow-up to modeling data, so if you haven't watched that lesson yet, please do so before proceeding. When we talked about data modeling, we described it as the process of mapping concepts of your application into data types. Now, data types are rarely isolated. They normally are connected in some way, they are related in some way. And in this particular lesson, we will use a data model around the concepts of books and authors and publishers to describe how these relationships can be obtained in the OutSystems platform. Before we go into the specifics of OutSystems, let's talk a little bit about how data is referenced in general terms in databases. You have the concept of a primary key. This is a way to uniquely identify a particular record of your data type. Now, primary keys can be of two kinds. They can either be a simple primary key, where a single attribute on that database table dictates the uniqueness of the record, or a composite primary key, whereby a collection of columns in the database table dictate a unique record. Now, from the viewpoint of a second data type that wants to reference a data type that has a primary key, you have the concept of a foreign key. The foreign key on a record of this second data type will hold the value of the primary key on the record of the first data type that it wants to reference. If for some reason you do not want to reference a record on the first data type, there's a special value that the foreign key can have, which is the null, indicating that this particular record doesn't bear an equivalent on the first data table. Now, in OutSystems, to implement a primary key, you need to have an identifier attribute. This is created for you automatically by the platform, but you can adjust its type to be either an integer, long integer, or text. These attributes are always mandatory, and in the case that you opt for an integer-based identifier, it will be auto-numbered, meaning that every time you insert a new row into the table of this entity, it will auto-generate the new ID. It is important to note that only simple primary keys exist in OutSystems, so you can only have one single attribute to index into a certain entity. So you cannot implement composite keys as we've seen in the first slide. To implement a foreign key in OutSystems, you use a reference attribute in the second entity that you have, and it needs to be of the data type of the identifier of the first entity that you want to point to. By setting these mandatory, you will be able to tell the database that it should enforce a non-null value every time a new record is inserted. When creating an attribute, if you name it entity name ID, by the rules of the name matching and the accelerator that we described in the other data modeling lesson, you will immediately get an attribute of the target entity identifier type. In case you want to insert a null, therefore stating that this record has no equivalent on the first entity, you can use the null identifier function. Let's look now into some of the usual patterns for data modeling using relationships. The first one is an extension entity, where its ID is actually of the type of another entity's identifier. This carries the concept that the second entity cannot live, cannot exist without the first entity first having been created. You must therefore always have created an author, obtained this ID, and use it explicitly in the biography that you're about to create in the database before it gets inserted. This extension or one-to-one relationship is called so because each single biography belongs only to a single author. And by view of the fact that author ID is a primary key of biography, you cannot have two biographies with the same author ID, therefore each author has at most one biography. It's easy to see that in concept these two entities could actually be the same. They could actually be joined together into a single entity, but for some design reason we decided not to do it explicitly and used instead the extension pattern. The second and most common pattern is the master detail pattern. In this case, the detail entity references the master entity. In our example, a publisher publishes multiple books. So each book has got a publisher ID referencing who is the publisher for that book. In your application, if you decided certain books may not have a publisher, they might be self-published, for example, you might want to not enforce this mandatory. Therefore, you would be able to create books without setting a publisher by leaving the publisher ID as a null identifier. This master detail or one-to-many pattern is called so because each publisher may have many books, and in turn, multiple books may belong to a single publisher. The third pattern that we're going to talk about is the junction entity. It is implemented by having a third entity that correlates two entities. Since a book can have multiple authors and an author can in turn write multiple books, it's easy to see that we cannot use a master detail relationship as we described previously. So we use this junction entity book author that references the author by its ID and references the book also by its ID. This junction entity leverages a many-to-many relationship because each author may have written multiple books, and each single book may have multiple authors. Now, how do you enforce the cohesion of your data model, of the data in your database? How do you enforce the referential integrity? In the OutSystems platform, you do so by specifying the delete rule on a reference attribute. You need to set the delete rule in every single entity reference attribute, and it needs to be one of the following values. It can be set to protect, which means that a record on the entity being referenced cannot be deleted as long as there are records in this entity that are pointing at it. This is the default setting. It can also be set to delete, which means that deleting a record on the entity being referenced will automatically delete the records on the current entity that point at it. Finally, there's the ignore option. This means that deleting a record on the entity being referenced will do nothing in the current entity. This does not guarantee, therefore, a referential integrity in this relation, and it's a very, very common pattern to use. In the interest of performance, the OutSystems platform also allows you to create indices over attributes in your entities. If you want to speed up fetches when filtering over a known set of attributes, you should create an index over those attributes. It's important to note that entity reference attributes already have automatically indexes created on them. It's worth noting that you can set an index to be unique, which allows the database to enforce that no two records will ever have the same combined value over the attributes that make up that unique index. This is quite handy, and among other things, it will allow you to simulate composite keys. Now, you've been doing all of this modeling, and it's quite useful to actually have a visual representation of your module so you know where you're at. And this is where the entity diagram comes in. Inside Service Studio, you can create as many entity diagrams as you want, and by dragging and dropping your entities into it, you will be able to get a visual representation of the data model of the relationships between the entities that you've dragged. In this screenshot, we can see our book-related data model and the relationships that all of the entities have with each other. Notice that the relationships between the entities are actually color-coded in the entity diagram. So in a strong gray, you have those entity references where the delete rule is protect. In red, you have those entity references where the delete rule is delete. And finally, on the light gray, you have ignore delete rules. And this is it for modeling data relationships without systems. See you guys on the next lesson.